Hello children, in this video I am going to explain you the digestion process which occurs in small intestine. Small intestine, already you all know that it is divided into three parts, that is the duodenum, jejunum and ileum. So one by one we will discuss that how the digestion takes place in each part. So first is duodenum. Duodenum part is having two glands, big glands, that is the liver and the pancreas. So pancreas is attached, which will release pancreatic juices, and liver will produce the bile, which is stored in gallbladder. Okay, remember the difference. Liver will produce bile and gallbladder will store bile, and whenever the requirement will be there, then it will be released into the duodenum. Now what happens in duodenum? So the process of emulsification takes place. What does this bile do? Bile will change the big fat globules into small droplets so that the digestion process will become easier. Okay, because it will increase the surface area for the digestion. Now the next is the pancreas. Pancreas will release pancreatic juices, and they are of three kinds: lipase, amylase and trypsin. It is, in short, to remember well, it can be written as LAT, L-A-T. You can memorize like this also, L-A-T. What does this lipase do? Lipase will change fat globules, small globules, into fatty acid and glycerol. So this is the end product after the digestion of the fat. Amylase, starch will change into maltose. Already the previous maltose will be also here, so that including that maltose will change into glucose with the help of the enzyme called the maltase. Okay, and the third one is the trypsin. Trypsin will change protein and peptides into smaller peptides and amino acids. So this process is a step-by-step process. Okay, they will keep on breaking the molecules, bigger molecules, into smaller ones, and the end product will be the amino acid. So fat will have the end product fatty acid and glycerol, starch will have the end product glucose, and proteins and peptides will have the end product after the digestion, that will be the amino acids. Now after digestion process, then the middle portion called the jejunum is there in the small intestine, and that will remain empty because most of the time it has been observed that when the postmortem is done, after the death it becomes empty immediately. So it is called the jejunum. Next part of the small intestine, that is called the ileum. The intestinal juices will be secreted, and the remaining one, the digestion will be over. Whatever is the smaller particles will be left to get digested. So here the digestion process will be done, and the wall of this ileum will do the process of absorption of the nutrients. Where? In the blood. In the blood, the nutrients will get absorbed. Now how the nutrients will get absorbed, that is the structure called the villi or the villus. Singular is the villus. So here the villi is there, and it is the finger-like projections which are present inside the ileum. And when the absorption process goes on, and there will be one more structure called the lymph vessel. They are known as the lacteals. So these lacteals absorb fat molecules which are digested. So that means the fatty acid and the glycerol are absorbed by the lacteals. Now the food will start moving further, that is in the large intestine it will move. So what happens in the large intestine? Now here the large intestine secretes no enzymes, only it absorbs much water but very little digested food from the contents, which mainly consists of undigested material. After much water is absorbed, the contents become semi-solid feces, and it passes into the rectum and are expelled out at intervals. Okay, so this is the temporary, you can say, the storage. The expulsion of the undigested remains of the food from the alimentary canal is called the feces.